Understanding the concept of homeostasis sets the basis for understanding our physiological systems. Successful homeostasis is critical to an organism's survival, while failure to maintain this balance can result in disease and, ultimately, death. Everything inside the human body starts from the stem cells. They later form the tissues that develop into organs. The organs come together to form organ systems that work in coordination under favorable conditions to ensure the proper functioning of the body's cells. Homeostasis is the process of how the body adapts to maintain the favorable conditions of the internal environment, using various mechanisms in order for cells to survive the constant external and internal changes. This means we have the ability to keep the internal environment of our body stable, even when the external condition is changing significantly. For example, the normal human body temperature is around 37 degrees Celsius or 98.66 degrees Fahrenheit. But whether you step outside under the summer heat or enter a fully air-conditioned room, your body temperature will remain stable at around 37 degrees Celsius thanks to homeostasis. We need the temperature adjusted around that value so the proteins inside our body can retain their shapes. Otherwise, it denatures and cannot function. Besides temperature, the body also needs some other conditions to remain at set values. The acidity around the cells, measured by the power of hydrogen or pH, has to be around 7.4. Values that are higher or lower may alter the chemical reactions inside the cells. To optimally carry out its function, the blood circulatory system needs to have a sufficient amount of blood pressure of around 120 millimeters of mercury of systolic and 80 millimeters of mercury of diastolic. Diverging too much from that number can cause either hypertension, which damages the arterial wall and increases the risk of heart attacks, or hypotension, which results in less supply of blood, oxygen and nutrition to the cells. A blood glucose level between 70 and 100 milligrams per deciliter is necessary for normal functions. Exceeding that may indicate diabetes is developing inside our body. The amount of water and the concentration of various ions in the blood need to be on a certain amount as well to let the transport of nutrients and waste occur properly. These are just a few out of hundreds of variables to maintain, which values actually have fluctuating normal ranges, but still allow an organism to thrive. To fulfill the requirements, homeostasis is facilitated by the fluids inside the body, mostly comprised of water. The circulatory system flows the blood to other organ systems aided by the fluids to obtain necessary nutrients and remove waste and byproducts. One of the most important forms of fluids is the blood plasma that can seep through the capillary wall to deliver nutrients. After the cells exchange substances with the surroundings, the fluid drains into the lymphatic vessel and re-enters the circulatory system. Some examples of how the organ systems maintain the body condition are: number 1. The respiratory system helps maintain carbon dioxide levels via breathing. Carbon dioxide is essential to maintain the blood pH through the formation of bicarbonate ions, but the excess level can be toxic. The respiratory system also supplies the necessary oxygen for cells to function. Number 2. The pancreas produces insulin and glucagon hormones to maintain the glucose level in the blood when it's becoming too high or low. Number 3. The liver aids in maintaining the body condition by converting excess glucose into glycogen for energy storage and neutralizing potential toxins to prevent cell damage. Number 4. The kidneys regulate our fluid balance by adjusting urine production to prevent dehydration and keep a normal blood pressure level. Additionally, it eliminates most of the metabolic waste to prevent it from accumulating in the body. Number 5. The skin releases sweat that evaporates to absorb heat from the body, thereby regulating our temperature while also removing excessive salt. Now, continuing our previous example, if our body fails to maintain a normal temperature of 37 degrees Celsius under the heat of the sun, then we could experience heat stroke and our body would lose consciousness. The doctors consider this state, when homeostasis is disrupted, as a state of disease. The mechanism through which homeostasis works and responds to various changes will be discussed in the next video: the negative and positive feedback systems. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.